Hello everyone, welcome to the third lecture of physics that is being important for you for a different competitive examination, just like MPSC, UPSC, SSC, CGL, CHSL, for a different competitive examinations that subject is being important for you. Okay, in the previous two lectures, this is our third lecture. In the previous two lectures, we had seen the physical concept of measurement and its units. We have seen different fundamental units, its SI units. Okay, in this session we will discuss about the previously asked question on this matter. Okay, without wasting time, let us start with it. Here is something about myself. I, Professor Suraj Ashok Garud. My qualification is BE Mechanical, Master in CAD/CAM, and currently I am working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Department. I have more than 12 years of experience in the teaching field. Okay, let's start with the first question. That is, read this question. It is, fever in typhoid is about 104 degree Fahrenheit, and where to what would be its value in Kelvin? Means here we are given a temperature in the Fahrenheit, and we have to convert that Fahrenheit into its Kelvin. Means here we are given a temperature is 104 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, now we should have to convert in its Kelvin. We have a formula for converting Fahrenheit into degree Celsius. So firstly we have been converted, and then we should convert into its Kelvin. Okay, so for converting, there is a formula, a degree Celsius equals to 5/9 multiplied by F minus 32. Wait a minute, what it is? F minus 5/9 into F minus 32. Okay, so let us convert it into degree Celsius. It is 5/9 into Fahrenheit is given 104 minus 32. If you do a calculation, 5/9, 104 minus 32 will be 72. Okay, 9 8s are, so it is 40 degree Celsius. Means firstly we have been convert Fahrenheit into Celsius. Now we are going to convert this degree Celsius into its Kelvin. For that we know that 1 degree Celsius equals to 273 Kelvin. Okay, so for that, as a 40 degree Celsius, it is 40 plus 273. So it would be 3, 7, 4, 11, 1, 1. So it is 313 Kelvin. This would be your final answer. Okay, this would be your final answer. So guys, you should just have to remind this formula, that is degree Celsius equals to 5/9 into F minus 32. Means here we have been convert degree Celsius, Fahrenheit into its degree Celsius. Okay, let us see next. Here, which is the unit of velocity? Okay, which means here you have given a different options, and from that options you should have to be select which is the unit of velocity. Generally velocity, we know that velocity, it is nothing but the distance per unit time or displacement with respect to time. We know that displacement will be noted as in meter, or SI unit of displacement is meter and time will be second. So the velocity of unit is meter per second. Next, here, which of the following unit has been added to the fundamental unit in 1974? Here it is been asked that this unit means among this unit which unit is being added in 1974. So we will discuss this about this unit one by one. This will be unit K. K is nothing but your Kelvin. This is your Kelvin. okay, and this will be the SI unit of temperature. It is related with the temperature. Next, A means ampere. SI unit of this will be the SI unit of current. This is related with the current. Next, CD is your candela, and it would be the related with the intensity of light. Intensity of light. Next, this is mole. Okay, mole means it will be the amount of substance. That is, it would be the SI unit of amount of substance. Amount of substance. Okay. Generally, that Kelvin is introduced to us in the season 1967 to 68. This will be the ampere will be early in 1921. Candela within the range of 1940s. So that mole is being introduced in the 1974. Okay, mole, that is amount of substance, will be added as a fundamental unit in 1974. Next. One by 86,400 part of one solar day in 20th century is. So what does it mean by? Okay, it should be 1 hour, it should be 1 minute, it should be 1 second, or it should be 0.1 second. So we are going to see it. We know that for 1 hour calculation, 1 hour, there will be a 60 minute. What would be second? 60 into 60. So it is 3600 second. Means in a 1 hour there will be 3600 second. Okay, and for it should be 24 hour. So for 24 hour, so what it is, we have to multiply it by 24 into 3600. If we do this, we should get an answer, that is 86,400. So one solar day means in a complete 24 hour, it would be written as a part of 1 by 86,400 part. So its answer is 1 second. Okay. Which of the following is a unit of momentum? We'll know that unit of momentum is, it is Newton second. Then some previous MPSC previously year question ask. We have to match the pair. Okay, here is your gravity. Gravity means G. G is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity. It would be in 9.81 meter per second square. So gravity will be meter per second square. Yeah. Then current. Recently we had seen the unit of current is your ampere. Velocity, meter per second. And resistance is your ohm. Okay, so simple is being there. Next, prefix for the multiple of 10 to the power of 18 is. Okay, means we have to, what it is, it would be tera, it would be peta, it would be exar, it would be zato. So tera means it would be 10 to the power of 12, peta means 10 to the power of 15, exam is 10 to the power of 18, and zato means जैटो मीन्स इट इज 10 to the power ऑफ -18 ना, डोंट कन्फ्यूज इन इट, ओके। एक्सा एंड जैटो, एक्सा विल बी 10 to the power ऑफ 18 पॉजिटिव एंड जैटो मीन्स 10 to the power ऑफ -18 निगेटिव। सो परफिक्स फॉर द मल्टीपल ऑफ 10 to the power ऑफ 18 इज योर एक्सा, एक्सा इज योर आंसर। नेक्स्ट, अ यूनिट ऑफ वैंडरवॉल्स कॉन्स्टेंट इज, वी हैव टू फाइंड वैंडरवॉल कॉन्स्टेंट फ्रॉम अमॉन्ग दिस, इट इज किलो पास्किल, ओके सॉरी, इट इज किलो पास्कल, इट इज किलो पास्कल डीएम क्यूब, इट इज किलो पास्कल एम क्यूब पर मोल और डीएम क्यूब पर मोल, और इट इज पास्कल डीएम प्लस टू द पावर ऑफ 6 पर मोल स्क्वेयर। सो दिस विल बी योर आंसर, इट इज पी ए डी एम प्लस टू द पावर ऑफ 6 पर मोल स्क्वेयर, और ऑल्सो वी कैन रिटर्न एज पी ए डी एम प्लस टू पावर ऑफ 6 मोल माइनस 2। नेक्स्ट, हियर अगेन मैच द पेयर, सो पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, करंट, चार्ज, कंडक्टेंस, एम्पियर, वोल्ट, मो, कूलम। पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस वी नो दैट इट इज बीइंग रिलेटेड विद द वोल्टेज, सो इट इज वोल्ट। करंट वी हैव सीन एम्पियर, चार्ज इन कूलम, कंडक्टेंस इज मो। वी नो दैट कंडक्टेंस इज द रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, कंडक्टेंस इज द रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, सो इट इज द यूनिट इज मो। लेट्स सी सम प्रीवियसली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन इन एसएससी, रीड इज क्वेश्चन। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स, एवरीबडी नोज दैट इट इज पास्कल, इट इज बॉयल, इट इज न्यूटन और वैट, सो इट इज फोर्स विल बी न्यूटन, ओके। नेक्स्ट, मीटर इन व्हीकल दैट कैलकुलेट द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द व्हीकल इज कॉल्ड, सो वॉट एवर द मीटर दैट शुड बी डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द व्हीकल, ओके। लेट्स सी स्पीडोमीटर, स्पीडोमीटर इज यूज फॉर nominating the speed of vehicle, it would be kilometer per hour, okay. Thermometer is for the temperature, kilometer is not such a devices, okay. So it is odometer is the devices or the meter in the vehicle that calculates distance covered by the vehicle, okay. This is important, most of the time it is asked, so odometer is that devices for the calculation of distance covered. Next, here what is the unit of measuring the amplitude of sound, okay, we have to measure the amplitude of sound, so it is decibel, okay, so this is decibel. Coulomb is the unit of charge, there will be no such a units, okay. Later, 1 nanometer is equals to, so 1 nanometer is equals to the, is it 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. 1 nanometer is equals to the 10 to the power minus 9 meter. We had seen a different prefix in the previous lectures. If you want, go through it. Okay. Here, 1 fathom is equals to, 1 fathom equals to, so it is 6 feet. It is 6 feet. So, 1 fathom is equals to 6 feet. Later deals with the next question we have to cover as much as many questions in this slide. Here, 1 kilometer is equals to how many miles? Such a question means 1 kilometer is equals to how many miles? So it is 0.62 miles. 0.62 miles is equals to the 1 kilometer. Then bar is the unit of, it is unit of temperature, note it will be temperature is Kelvin is the unit of temperature, heat is not the temperature, it will be some joule, atmospheric pressure. So here bar is the unit of atmospheric pressure. Okay, how many dynes are there in 1 gram weight? In 1 gram weight, how many dynes are present? So it is 981 dynes. It is 981 dynes. Okay, joule is the unit of, joule is the unit of, you will see here is given temperature, pressure, energy and heat. From that unit of joule, temperature unit, temperature ka unit kya hai? It is Kelvin. Pressure unit bar. So you guys, you have been confusing it, what it would be related with the energy or heat. Okay, generally both the systems will be related with the joule. Okay, but basically in if such a question is to be asked, so in that case that joule is the unit of, joule is the unit of energy, joule is the unit of energy. How many arcs are there in 1 joule? In 1 joule, how many arcs has to be present? So it is 107 arcs equals to the 1 joule. Very small time interval are accurately measured by time interval. Small time interval will be accurately measured by white drop, quartz clock, atomic clocks or pulsar. So it is atomic clocks. Atomic clocks are the devices to measure a very small interval of time, and it is being very accurate. Next, 1 horsepower is equals to, 1 horsepower, you know that it is 746 watt. Kilowatt is a unit to measure work, power, electricity or current. It is kilowatt power. Kilohertz, hertz, okay, hertz, you know that hertz, power used by current of 1 ampere. No, electromagnetic radio frequencies, yes, it is electromagnetic radio wave frequencies, not voltage and not electric resistance. So kilohertz is a unit for electromagnetic radio wave frequencies. Fathom, we have already seen fathom, 6 feet, in the previous question. So it is generally that would be measured in terms of depth, okay, nautical depth. So fathom is the unit of depth. Reading of barometer going down is an indication of, it would be snow, storm, intense and rainfall. Okay, so as the reading of barometer is going down, means what happened, barometer is a device to measure a pressure, means the pressure in that barometer is being going down. Okay, slowly it is going to be down, means the pressure is going down. As the pressure is going down, it will be chances to be rainfall. It would be chances to be rainfall. If suddenly that barometer reading goes down, sudden effect is being over there, at that time there will be chances to produce a storm also. Okay, but in a such a in this question the answer will be rainfall. Next is, knot is a unit of speed of which of the following? Nautical mile kahan pe use hota hai? Aeroplane, light waves, ship, sound waves? No, it is in ship. So knot is a unit of speed of which the following? It is a ship. The unit of energy in EMK system is joule. It is joule. The instrument used to measure electric current, ye sabko pata hi hoga, it is ammeter. Ammeter is used to measure electric current. Electrometer is being a different device that use a very small charge or potential difference. Galvanometer is used for measurement of voltage. Spectrometer that is used to measure the depth. Name of the instrument used to measure the relative humidity. Relative humidity. So hydrometer, hygrometer, barometer or mercury thermometer. So it is hygrometer. Hygrometer is a device that would be used to measure relative humidity. HP stands for, it is harmonic progression, horsepower, both A and B. So it is both A and B. HP stands for harmonic progression also, HP progression, HP AP, or it is also horsepower. Next is Richter scale is used for measuring. Richter scale is used for measuring density of liquid. No, intensity of earthquake. Yes, it is intensity of earthquake. So whenever we are dealing with the intensity of earthquake, it is a Richter scale is being over there. Okay. Next, the instrument used in aircrafts to measure the altitude above a fixed level. Above fixed level, ammeter is not there. Instrument measure the altitude. We have to measure the altitudes. Audiometer is not there. Anemometer is not there. It is used to measure the speed. So it is altimeter. So it is altimeter is that instrument used in aircrafts to measure the altitude above a fixed level. Next is which of the following instrument is used for recording earthquake waves? Earthquake waves. You know that it is seismograph. It is seismograph. So seismograph is an instrument to be used for recording earthquake. Next, here the energy of food is measured in, pata hoga sabko, energy kiske measure karte, itna calorie khaya, utna calorie khaya, that is in terms of calories. Telescopic is used for viewing. किसके लिए होता है टेलीस्कोप? क्या देखने के लिए? इट इज यूज फॉर डिस्टेंट ऑब्जेक्ट, नो, दूर का देखने के लिए, तारे तारे वगैरह. नेक्स्ट, वेलोसिटी ऑफ विंड इज मेजर्ड बाय. वेलोसिटी ऑफ विंड अभी देखा, अभी पता है मैंने, दैट इज एनीमोमीटर. एनीमोमीटर इज अ डिवाइस दैट शुड बी यूज फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, मेजरमेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी ऑफ विंड. 1 inch is equals to, 1 inch is equals to how much centimeter? It is 2.67 centimeter. It is 2.67 centimeter. Lux is the SI unit of, it is intensity of illumination, it is luminous efficiency, luminous flux, or luminous intensity. So it is luminous intensity. Lux is being less as the SI unit of luminous intensity. Then transformer is used, it is used to increase the DC voltage, or it is used to increase or decrease the AC voltage, decrease the DC voltage, or convert DC into AC. No, it is used for the increase or decrease AC voltage. It can be used for both the purpose, that should be increase or decrease the AC voltage. So thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Please like it, subscribe it, and share it. Please go through the previous lectures. You should have clear your concept. So thank you everyone. We'll see in the next lecture. Bye.